Welcome back to the channel, everyone. In today's video, I'm going to go through and show you how on a particular store, a client of mine, where we've actually expanded from Australia into the US, campaign struggling a little bit. We're really hovering around this 1.9x ROI, and the client really wants to get it above 2. So I'm just going to go through and do some really quick optimizations around how I would improve that, how I would think about it, given that it is in a new country, a new market, and just what things I would look at on the website, in the store, and just what improvements that I would make, recommendations for improvements to the client, and just kind of to show you an insight as to how I think about these issues. So let's just get right into it. Very, very basic smart shopping campaign at the moment here, guys. We'll probably look to transition this to a performance max campaign, given that that whole transition is occurring. And I may do that in a later video. But for now, given that we can transition a performance max pretty much straight into a smart shopping campaign, we just don't add those asset groups in. I'm just going to go through and show you what I would do just from a top level shopping view. And this would be the case if you had a standard campaign, performance max, or smart shopping campaign. This is just how to think about Google Ads and e-commerce generally. So we'd look at the data and go, what's going on here? What's driving this underperformance? And to be honest, I'd probably look at a longer period than 30 days, just because 30 days, given we're only spending, you know, 200, 250 per day max, let's go back several months and just see that ROI actually drops a little bit. But what I can see here is that conversion value has actually dropped off as well. You can see it was much, much higher over here. And I like to look at it more on a monthly basis. And as you can see in May, we had a much, much better performance. I'll actually put in cost here. And I actually look at these graphs, quite a bit. As you can see, you know, we spent 7,500, but we made 15. Here we're spending 3.5, we're only making 4 and a bit. And to be honest, like, this isn't the main store. This is just like, let's just test this in the US, see how it goes. It's doing well in Australia, you know, doing 50, 60K per month. You know, for a store in Australia, that's not too bad for just a small business that actually has a physical shop front as well, and actually offers some online services as well. So really their revenue is well over 100,000 per month, which is great. But what do we need to do here? How can we get it back to here? What was happening in May? And yes, e-commerce sales probably have declined a little bit. But what's caused this, and what can we do to improve it? Now let's dive in. What we always do is we want to go into this and in greater detail. And to be honest here, it's actually best selling AU products. So we've just done our best selling products. We're not selling their entire range here, but let's look at the product level, even look at auction insights as well first, just for a quick sneak peek to see who we're competing against. And we're competing against people like Amazon, Walmart, eBay, GNC, which is a supplement store. So we can actually go and look at their listings and see what are they doing, what are their websites like. So this is the process I look at. I start top level and then drill deeper and deeper and deeper. And so let's look at GNC. Let's see what they do. Amazon and eBay and stuff like that, they play in so many auctions that quite often it's quite hard to understand whether or not you're really competing with them and what's coming up. But we would look at their best-selling products and then see if we can do any better. Now, compared to our website, this is a much, much nicer, much better laid out website, has a bigger range, is definitely a higher quality website. So straight away, I will show you this website really quickly. One of my first comments to my clients would be, okay, your website's good, but their website is significantly better, right? It's just significantly better. It's not even comparable, these two websites. They've got a better range. It's, you know, there's much, much, much more variety. It's laid out better into digestion and things like that, where our website just really has protein, superfood, supplements. It has it laid out, but it doesn't have it to the same level. So these guys are definitely going to have a higher average order value, and their advertising dollar is going to be stretched much further. Obviously, these guys are a much bigger business as well. So first thing is, go and look at your competitors. You can go into something like iSearch From and do a search, and we'll go country, United States, and we'll go they sell BPC, oh, actually we'll just go alkaline supplements and see if we can come up, because this is kind of their point of difference, I guess. And as you can see, there's tons and tons of competitors here. So it is a competitive space for that particular range of products, and we're not really even coming. And it doesn't surprise me, given we're not spending a lot and it isn't what we've optimized our keywords for. But maybe what I'll do is I'll look at our best-selling product here. Jump into here and then have a look at, okay, I'll also always sort by cost and then have a look at what's getting us a poor ROI, and then I'll pause it, right? That said, I know that these four here are good high selling lines, so I will probably like to just improve these first, and I actually shouldn't have excluded this. I will re-include this one back in, this product, just because I know I can do things to improve the title here as well. But let's grab BPC 157, because this is a well-known supplement, and let's see if we come up for this in an auction. Yes, we do. We're actually number two here. And what I would then say is, how can I improve my listing versus someone else? So, okay, I've got free delivery. Awesome. I've got a sale on, which definitely draws the eyes of competitors here. But then it's like, what are all these things? And I'd have to clarify with my client, what are these other ones here? And why are we so much more expensive? So I'll just save this and send it to them in an email. So I'd have a look here. Okay, like, what are all these different things? Like, how is ours different? It is a different product. But how can I relay that better? Like, is it the amount of BPC is higher than what we have? Is it the amount of tablets? What is it? And how can we differentiate? Now, it does look different. The listing looks quite good, but I think the title could definitely be improved. And I don't exactly know how much I'm getting in each of these and things like that. So if I can get customer reviews on here as well, I think that will improve the listing too. But it's nice to see that when someone types that, we are coming up quite high. It's just, okay, we're actually coming up a few times. There must be a few different sizes, or actually this looks like it's the Australian store that's coming up. So I wonder if it's, maybe we're selling something more like this as opposed to what these guys are, but I just need to understand what it is. I mean, this does say for research only, so I actually don't know what this is, but maybe we would look at the website. So it's actually a French website here. Looks like it sells a lot of kind of health-related things. You could try and search for this BPC 157 and see if it comes up. Not coming up. Doesn't matter. So that's basically what I'd look at. Look at competitors. How can we improve this listing? What can I do to make it better? What can I do to make sure that I get more sales? So that's one of the steps we can do there, guys. Competitors, then we're looking at their websites, what we can do to improve, layout, nicer layout, higher quality images, better quality titles, descriptions, and an overall website. So that's probably the first thing I would look at. I'm going to actually add this back in because I want to go in and play around with the titles a little bit. So I'll go to my apps. So we'll go to our sales channel, then our Google sales channel here. We'll go to the products here, and we actually want to check, are there any issues? So this was recently taken on by us in terms of the US account. The client went and set it up on their own, so there's plenty and plenty of issues with it. Obviously, it needs a refund policy as well as, well, it's saying a GTIN, but we can just mark it as a custom product. So what we'll do in here, guys, is the products that we wanted to rename, we'll actually edit here in the Google fields. So we can mark this as a custom product if they don't have an MPN, or we can ask the client for that. We can add the Google product category, which will help as well. But actually what we're first going to do here is let's edit this, right? Muscle matrix, lean muscle builder. And then it's like, what's the size? Let's have a look here. 60 capsules. by alkaline superfoods. And that's perfect, right? I like to put the brand name. You can do that with feed rules, but this is just an example. This is what we would do. The URL handle, we can just leave that. This is, we could add a little bit here, but I don't think it's going to make a huge difference. But I even just think this muscle matrix, lean muscle builder, 60 capsules. This actually gives the customer a bit more information there. It doesn't need to be huge keyword stuffing. We can do that down the track if we find that it's not doing well or we need to improve it even further. This here, it's not doing too bad. This was the one we changed that only had a ROAS of 1.32. Express weight loss, we might go into this one and change as well. And what we're going to do, express weight loss capsules by alkaline superfoods. And again, how many? It's 60 capsules. We'll just go 60 by alkaline superfoods. Click save. At least now, if someone types weight loss capsules, weight loss powders, things like that, it'll come up. So that's that one fixed as well. Prohelix, everything else seems not too bad. It was the testosterone booster, I think that, yeah, this one here. Alkaline testosterone booster. Let's fix that one up as well. 60 capsules by alkaline superfoods. We won't go, but here's why I don't want to put too many words into here, because I don't want Google to flag that this is a product that's banned or something like that. So I don't want to change it too much and then we get that as an issue, because that can happen on these sort of supplements. It is a downside to them. So that's another factor there. So here I'm trying to, okay, let's see what we can do to improve the website, improve these campaigns here. Let's go in and add the product categories as well. And then once we do that, let's actually lower the budget a little bit. So if it's running on 200 a day, maybe we drop it down to 150 and see if it can actually improve the quality of traffic. But what I'll probably do in this next video, guys, is transfer this to a performance max. I'll wait and see for probably at least a week to see how this goes potentially. But I will check in with the client, see what they want to do about all the other little factors. But this is just a really quick optimization. You can get much, much deeper. Like we can look at images, more descriptions, go deeper on the titles. But for a smart campaign, normally just dropping the budget can actually start to bring you in higher quality traffic. We'll probably show you on things like the display network, Gmail, Google, Discovery and all those other areas, probably just a little bit less, and it'll focus more on shopping. But hope this has helped just thinking about how to optimize it. But obviously go through, pause anything that's really doing poorly. Like this testosterone booster, the only reason I'm not pausing it yet, even though it's spent quite a bit and not really delivered much of a result, is that I know it does well in Australia. So I think we can get it to improve. It just needs a bit of love and attention. But I'll let you know how this one goes, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.